what would you do if you found 2,000 skeletons in your closet?
I would cancel my dog's credit card.
What do you reckon?
I live in a Catholic church conversion, so it is likely.
Does it feel spooky?
It doesn't feel spooky. My Nana was really upset, but it's been deconsecrated so that you can swear in it and do all sorts.
I expect that happened before, don't you?
She checked.
Oh, really? Okay. Mm-hmm. Is she Catholic?
She is Irish Catholic, so right. I mean, and dead.
And yet she still came over to check.
That's a little love. Too nosy for her own good.
2,000 skeletons. 2,000 skeletons. You suddenly discover them. What are you going to do
that
with them?
That is a game of sardines that went too far.
Yes, very wrong.
A hidden mass grave.
So a collection of thousands of skeletons was discovered in Rome in 1578, and nobody knew who they were, and the church thought, this is fantastic, because for several decades, the Protestants had been stealing their relics, and what they really needed was new ones. So they employed psychics to try and see if there were any martyrs amongst them, and a few of them had an M inscribed nearby, and they thought, that'll do, we'll have them, even though, like, Marcus was a really popular name at the time. And when they found a likely candidate, they gave them a new name and a backstory, and they sent them out to the churches across Europe. They couldn't actually sell them as relics, but what they could do is they could charge them transport, decoration, induction, blessing. They would dress them up, they would cover them in jewels, like this, and put them on display. The real problem with this was they didn't send them with any instructions. So it's like a flat pack without instructions.
Put a bit of makeup on it.
So loads of the skeletons were just...
bunged together.
Honestly, just all over the shop.
This was like the House of Lords, isn't it?
But there was a huge rush to name your children after the saints. So when Saint Valentine would go on display, boys would be called Valentine, girls were called Valentina. And in the most extreme cases in some villages, up to half the children would have the same name because they're all named after the skeleton. Yeah. And very, very rich people would try and buy relics of a saint who had the same name as them. It's like a personalised licence plate that you get today. It's the same thing. And hundreds remain to this day. Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.